See, like, I genuinely, since the beginning, I've never been a big fan of tea. I've always been like more of a co- I mean, I never knew about coffee really early on. I never drank it. But tea wasn't something that really, you know, got
Correct.
me going in general.
Yeah, and it's
And the
gone.
day I started having coffee, I was like, where have you been all my
Been
life?
all your life?
Why have I been without you?
Right.
It's like a lost love that I got back
True.
in life.
True.
But no, I again, I do love drinking coffee every day, but I am a complete novice or a beginner in anything related to
नया
कॉफी.
छोकरा है
हाँ, बहुत नया छोकरा. मुझे मुझे ये नहीं पता है कि व्हाट इज द
इसका
डिफरेंस
टाइम आ
बिटवीन लाइक एन
गया.
एस्प्रेसो एंड एन अमेरिकानो और व्हाट. द ओनली डिफरेंस आई नो इज व्हाट इज लाइक आइस्ड कॉफी एंड नॉर्मल एस्प्रेसो. बिकॉज़ हाँ, आइस्ड कॉफी में
इसमें
आइस है, दूसरा दूसरा
हाँ
गर्म होता है. इतना पता है. दैट आई नो, दैट आई नो. लाइक
वाओ,
दैट्स द
दैट्स
ओनली
रियली सेइंग समथिंग, बिकॉज़ you know, and that's what really the third wave coffee movement is all about, you know. And before we really talk about third wave coffee, it's only logical to talk about what's second wave coffee and what's first wave coffee,
Yeah,
right?
true.
I mean, if I had to make it as simple as
I mean,
I
it is just bean water, isn't it? It is
I
just
know
bean water.
I've been water, now I'm ice.
Oh my god.
Okay, lame joke alert. Right, so yeah, bean water and first wave coffee, sort of first wave coffee. I mean, if you want to understand it chronologically, somewhere ended the first wave of coffee, somewhere ended in the 70s, right? Up till the 70s, coffee was really viewed as a commodity. It was just something that you had in the morning to wake up, and that's about it. It was like dark liquid in a metal cup that you just chucked down. Didn't really think too much about taste or flavor, but you know it woke you up, right? So you can look at the first, and again, I'm really like,
Is there like any historic, you know, kind of importance to why coffee even started in general?
so I'm not that well read into the history, but what I do know is that coffee, in the beginning was as a commodity as readily available as tea. It's just that it sort of had like a smaller group of people who were takers, so it as a general rule of thumb became more expensive. Of course, tea was historically discovered, at least as per records, tea was discovered much before in China, accidentally. But
Yeah, when there was like a leaf fell into
yeah, like
someone's cup of
how
water.
idealistic is that? I don't
Yeah,
buy that, man.
Every time I hear that story, it's so funny. Like, just a leaf fell into that cup of water, and then he drank it, and
I
that
mean,
emperor really, really liked
who
it, so he
does
just
that?
tea was discovered that way.
No, I don't buy that, but
I
if
mean, you know what? Most, I think, discoveries are by accident,
yeah,
so I can kind of see why.
including having children. Yeah, that we don't want to go there. Tea is a happier accident, right?
I don't know if that would be a happy accident or not.
No,
Depends on
no.
the person.
True.
But
Right, so
enough
back
about
to more
that.
interesting topic of bean water,
Yes.
right? So bean water,
Bean
right? So the 1970s, I think, is the last time for first wave coffee, when it was just basically a commodity, like just something you had to wake up. 70s onwards, like probably till 2010,
Yeah.
you really saw coffee being used more as an experience. People had this idea of trying to do it differently, trying to take the entire process from A to Z and doing it differently. They came up with shops which were just serving coffee. Like earlier, you just had diners that gave you coffee along with what you ordered. Now you had shops where you could just go and have coffee. That's
Yeah, that would be like a big improvement
yeah.
for people. At least, like, I think, I guess the number of people who must be drinking coffee must have
Correct.
improved increased by then as well.
Correct. So coffee was still a commodity
Yeah.
in second wave, but the second wave saw a larger importance being given to the experience of having a coffee. But still, coffee was still a medium for conversations.
I think it still is, man.
Yeah,
Like
a medium.
coffee, I think it'll be always be a medium for
Yeah, but
conversations,
that's
right?
exactly where third wave comes in and says that we're doing it differently. So third wave is very zen. It's entirely about the coffee. I mean, you could go to third wave coffee shops and just see people not talk to each other, just be
Just
consumed in
be
their cup of
consuming the
coffee.
coffee, yeah.
Third wave is where you're seeing art being infused in coffee. It's the rise of crafting coffee. It's a lot more experimentation. It's shunning the older methods, so.